Today I will be doing some parts polishing, and rather than bore you absolutely to death, I'm just going to show my process that I'm going to use to bring these parts back from the pitted hell that they were to something kind of, you know, certainly something that's going to look good on the bike. These are pitted so bad from the sandblasting that I did, but it's the only way to get the chrome off. So I'm kind of left with very few options. The re-chroming process, this stuff here would have been probably $1,500 to $2,000. I'll set up my cameras and probably be the better part of a day. This is very time consuming. You know, do this in a day, one of these in a day. And it's gonna be, I'll save these for last. Because these are good. I'm going to have to get some more equipment to do these. To get some smaller flap wheels from Prime. From my friend Cam there. And these I'll save for last. And these are going to be a lot of work. It's going to be awful. I'm not looking forward to that at all. But it's all I have. It's my only recourse. So, that's what I'll do. I'll work on these. This is probably for me. I'm going to say probably a couple months worth of work. So, better get started. This is yellow stuff is silly putty. So, what I've done here, these are the side covers, obviously, and I gotta get all this old crappy plating off. It didn't survive on the aluminum. The steel is okay, but not the aluminum. Now when I took this piece down, it looked just like that. I didn't know anything about plating. I was told that you cannot blast chrome plating off, but I took this part down to the plating place to see if I get a quote for plating. It was ridiculous. So the option I was given was to have it blasted, have media blasted. So that's when I asked, you know, can you do that? And he said, yeah, you can do it with aluminum, no problem at all. Because the aluminum is a softer medium and the plating isn't going to stick as well. So all of that old flaking stuff was blasted off and then I polished this at home. Now this is a total amateur job, but it looks a hell of a lot better than the original did. So that's my intent here, is to take these down to the blasters where I did. That part, by the way, which was chrome-plated aluminum, if I can get all that pitting removed and get all these to, you know, just a dull finish, well, then I can bring them home, sand them, and then polish them. All right, garage is cleaned up. I hate seeing a mess. And I'm about ready to take all of this stuff down for sandblasting. I've got all the pieces that I want to get all the plating off, clutch cover, the solenoid bracket, the oil filter, the centerpiece that belongs here, actually, in the ring, the gold ring is off. That's a different piece. What else do I have? The front exhaust valve cover, the right side passenger footrest, the left side passenger footrest. These pieces, I'm just loosely laying them out here because I've got to be able to get both sides of these. But this is the backrest assembly right here, so two parts along the fender and the part where the pad goes. Duct tape over the sight glass, pack with silly putty. There's duct tape over these as well. All the openings in here, the orifices. Duct tape, silly putty, and then more duct tape. And I'm going to be real gentle around these areas anyway. I just want to get all this plating off. The obvious parts. The front, the sides, the top. Things that are really visible. And the idea here is once I get all this plating off, I'll be able to sand those down and polish them. I'm back from the sandblasters now, and you can see just how aggressive that is. Very aggressive. So I had to be as careful as I could. Of course, that peeled right off. Wasn't going to stop that. So all of this stuff now has to be sanded. Okay, first round of cleanup is done. That's the sandblasting. I don't know what the heck that stuff is, but man, oh man, you got to be careful with it. It'll eat this stuff alive. A sandblaster actually ate holes in the plywood. But it got all the chrome off, which is cool. And the next step, of course, is to sand and get all of the big, deep pits out. And that's actually a little bit harder than what it looks. Best thing for that is a grinding wheel with a couple of, I think they call these flap wheels, and then these really aggressive pads. And you can get this done pretty quick. This is about 20 minutes worth of work. And already you can see a little bit of a shine. So the important thing here is to keep shape. And you are taking off material with those wheels, so you got to be really careful how you do that. And then once you have it in this stage, the next stage is actually sanding it. So you're going to sand it with, you know, 200, 300 grit, somewhere start around there, and then move your way up through 400, 600, 800, and even, you know, probably go into the 1,000 range. But the idea is to get rid of all the scratches. The next step is to polish. I'm going to give it a try. I'm going to just see how this one comes up, because it should come up pretty quick. It's aluminum. I'll throw my polishing wheel on here and see how that goes. So, I don't know, was that 5 minutes, 6 minutes on the wheel, and I've got the pitting down under control. Okay, you can kind of see where this is going already. I've got to fit it on the bike and just remind myself which way this goes, because I don't want to spend a lot of time polishing something that nobody's going to see. That inside part, by the way, gets repainted in black. But just one round of grinding on the wheel, and I've shaped the metal pretty much as far as I need to shape it. Now it just needs to smooth, and I'll do that with the hand sander. Round one of sanding, and this is really cheap Amazon sandpaper, so I really don't know what grit that is, or even if it is what it says on it, but this will be the next stage, and all you're doing at this point in time is getting out the big gouges and making sure that it's smooth, because when you polish these things,
They have to be smooth. They can't have any divots in them or else they'll look really bad. So that's the point right now, and this is the purpose. You're kind of still shaping metal at this time. And the next few steps will just be getting the finish smoother and smoother. You can actually see that it's starting to get a little shiny. So this finish that's on here now is a pretty uniform finish. The brush marks you can get off with a little bit of alcohol. But if you like this look, if you like that brushed aluminum look, you can either do it with lines on it and you can keep it like this with the wheel. And then the other step from here is now that it's smooth and it's uniform in finish, you can see if there's any deep gouges or deep scratches. And from this point, you can finish it. Polish it if you like. I'm going to be sanding this a little bit more all the way around, and then once I get it sanded, I'm going to clean it, and then I'll look at whatever the next steps will be in the polishing sequence, because again, I want these to look like chrome. Okay, so that's about it for the mechanical sanding, with the machine anyway. You can see that there's a really nice sheen finish on this. I just finished it up with some 600 and it still has some, some visible score markings on it, but that'll come out. That's the 600 grit, and that'll come out with the next sanding, and you just keep progressively working on that. But the rest of the part looks almost new. That wire wheel, I got in all the little small bits with the Dremel tool inside here. Like I said, this is going to get painted black again. But everything that needs to be shiny and chromey is going to be this part, and all of the face, and part of the back if you desire to get down your hands and knees and have a look at this thing, which I doubt. That's not the purpose of this. So I'll go and keep working on this for a little bit. And all I'm going to do, I'm not going to record it, but I'm just going to progressively go down to about, I'm going to say, probably around 12 or 1500 before I actually break out the polishing wheel. And that'll go on the grinder. So next step, off camera, a couple stages of hand sanding, not wet, just I'm just going to take some small bits of sandpaper and I'm just going to go over and get all the minor marks out of it. There's not really much as far as pitting goes. It's all just sandpaper marks at this point in time. Not too concerned about the holes. Like I said, not too concerned about anything else. Just wanted to get this part looking better than what it was. This is the last stage of sanding that I'm going to do on this. What I used was a couple, just some foam pads. Really, really soft foam pads. I think they're in the range of the 1000 to 1500 range, somewhere in there. That's all I need, really. Again, I'm going to put this on the polishing wheel now. If you've watched some of my other videos, when I restored the forks, this is about the finish that I had completed on the forks. If you like that brushed look, you can stop at any time. It's not about being right or wrong. It's about finding the look that you want. And I really do like this brushed aluminum look. Over the chrome even, but again, I'm restoring the bike and it's supposed to be as close to original, at least the way it looks. And, of course, in another 10 or 15 years, I didn't want the chrome peeling anyway, so hopefully I'm going to be able to get this on the wheel and get it looking pretty shiny. It's not a big process. I got some of the cheapest wheels money can buy. They really don't even work that well. I've got to get some better ones when I actually do the final, but it'll at least give me an idea of where I'm sitting. And the final polishing will be a last thing to do anyway before putting all the parts back on the bike. So, last step here for sanding. Next is polishing. So this is what I started with, and that's the result, the end result over there. Again, you know, just the flap wheel to get all the heavy pits down, and sanding to keep it fair, and then some hand sanding towards the end. None of it was wet, it was all just dry sanding. This one turned out pretty happy with this. It's still warm, but you can see how well it works and how well it turns out. The next stage is I got to get all the bumps and the big pits out. This is what it looks like when I start with the flap wheel. And then after a little bit of sanding, they start looking a little bit better, a little brush finish. And then, you know, the polished look afterwards. I think these things look great. So a lot of work, but I think it's worth it. Definitely think it's worth it.
So that's it. That was a lot of work. That's a couple months worth of work. The sandblasting to get all the old pitted chrome off. Sanding. Brutal. And everything else, all the other work that went into it. And, you know, I saved myself a ton of money and learned a lot about the proper way of polishing. You know, it ended up quite a bit of trial and error, I guess you'd say. So I'm happy with it, really happy with it. It's not perfect. It's better than what it was. And this is it. I'll leave it at this. And, you know, pretty pleased. Thanks for sticking in there with me. This was a long one. And again, apologize for, you know, taking so long. But I got to do this stuff in between work. And this is the best I can do. So I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for tuning in. And we'll get you another video here pretty soon.